Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you on the video lecture in the subject Gas Power Cycles. And this is lecture number 1 on Gas Power Cycle. We are going to discuss about the Otto cycle, the thermodynamic cycle, Otto cycle. The topic to be covered in this lecture is air standard cycle, Otto cycle, air standard efficiency of the Otto cycle, and the mean effective pressure of the Otto cycle. And the learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to describe the Otto cycle, derive the efficiency of Otto cycle and mean effective pressure. So, describe the Otto cycle, it is Bloom's level 1, remember level. And derive the efficiency of Otto cycle and the mean effective pressure is lecture learning level number 2, that is understanding. So, the Bloom's level are 1, remember, 2, understand, 3, apply, 4, analyze, 5, synthesis, and 6, create. Air standard cycle. A thermodynamic cycle is defined as a series of changes of state such that the final state is identical with the initial state. So, that is what we studied earlier in thermodynamics. So, the PV diagram 1 to 2 is a process and 2 to 1 is also a process. The two processes constitute a cycle. So, initial and the final states are identical. So, when the working fluid is air, then it is called as air standard cycle. So, general definition of thermodynamic cycle, then when the working fluid is air, then it is called as air standard cycle. The thermodynamic cycle classification, there are different types of classification. First classification, according to the application, this may be power cycle or refrigeration cycle. So, the power cycle, they are used to produce power from the heat to produce the work. For example, Otto cycle, diesel cycle, petrol engine, diesel engine, gas engine, they are power producing devices. The basic thermodynamic cycle on which the petrol engine, diesel engine, the gas engines operating, they are called as power cycles. And refrigeration cycle, which is low temperature cycle. So, refrigeration cycle will absorb the heat energy and produces low temperature. So, the refrigerator is working on the refrigeration cycle. Then according to the change of phase, so this may be gas power cycle or vapor power cycle. So, gas power cycle, the working substance is gas throughout. For example, Otto cycle, diesel cycle and the Brayton cycle. Vapor power cycle, the working substance, it undergoes change of phase, vapor phase, liquid phase, the combination of vapor and the liquid phase. For example, Rankine cycle, what we studied in thermodynamics. Rankine cycle is the vapor power cycle. Steam power plant is working on the Rankine cycle. And the refrigeration cycle is also vapor power cycle. So, in the refrigeration cycle, the refrigerant vapor is converted into vapor and liquid alternatively. So, that is also vapor power cycle. According to the initial and the final state of the working fluid, final condition of the working fluid, it may be closed cycle or open cycle. So, closed cycle, they are hypothetical. So, they are theoretical cycle and open cycle. All the practical cycles are open cycle. So, we know the open system, closed system. Open cycle means mass and energy crosses the boundary of the system. Closed cycle means mass remains constant, only the energy crosses the boundary of the system. The assumptions to analyze the air standard cycles. We assume certain things for analyzing air standard cycle. Air standard cycle is a theoretical cycle, but the practical cycles are gas power cycle. For example, in the case of petrol, real petrol engine, real diesel engine, the working substance is gas. But in the Otto cycle, diesel cycle, we assume the working substance is air. And in the theoretical cycle, we assume that the cycle is closed, whereas the real time petrol engine, diesel engine, they are open cycle. So, for the assumptions are, the working fluid behaves as perfect gas. So, it obeys all the perfect gas equations, PV equal to MRT. The mass of the working fluid is constant, that is what closed system. So, we assume that M equal to constant all the processes that constitute the cycle are reversible. So this is the theoretical cycle, hypothetical cycle. All the processes are reversible, but practically all the processes in the petrol engine or diesel engine, they are irreversible. The heat supply and heat rejection are through constant temperature source and the sink respectively, and there is no chemical reaction in the cycle. There is no chemical process. So heat is supplied and rejected with a constant temperature source and the sink. The properties of working fluid remains constant. So what are the properties? Cp, Cv, gamma, gas constant, R, everything remains constant. No heat loss between the system and the surrounding. That is, the system is completely insulated. So the heat transfer is zero. The kinetic and potential energies of the working fluids are neglected. So there is only one kind of energy transfer. So heat and work. So there is no change in the kinetic energy or the potential energy. So these are all the assumptions for the air standard cycle. And this is the first cycle. We have to review the engine nomenclature. So this is the engine. We have the piston is reciprocating inside the engine. We have the valve and we have the bore. This is the diameter of the cylinder. And we have the top dead center, bottom dead center. And the piston is reciprocating within the top dead center, the bottom dead center. So we have the connecting rod connecting the piston with the crankshaft. So the first is cylinder bore. The diameter of the cylinder, the nominal inner diameter of the working cylinder is called as cylinder bore, and it is designated by the letter D, and it is usually expressed in millimeter. And the piston area, the cross sectional area of the piston, the area of circle of diameter equal to the cylinder bore is called as piston area. The area of circle of diameter equal to the diameter, the cylinder bore equal to the cylinder bore is called as piston area, and it is designated by A. It is usually expressed in square centimeter. So, pi by 4 d square, that is the piston area, the cross-sectional area of the piston. And the stroke length, the nominal distance through which the working piston moves between two successive reversal of its direction of motion is called as stroke, and it is designated by letter L and is expressed in millimeter. Stroke length, the distance between top dead center and the bottom dead center. And the dead center, the position of the working piston and the moving parts which are mechanically connected to it at the moment when the direction of the piston moving is motion is reversed at the either end of the stroke is called as dead center. So when the actually when the piston is moving from the bottom dead center towards the top, at one point the direction of motion is reversed. That point is called as the dead center. So there are two dead center, top dead center and the bottom dead center. So TDC and the BDC. The TD is the dead center when the piston is farthest from the crankshaft. So TDC, look at TDC. So this is the crankshaft. This is farthest from the crankshaft. And the BDC is the dead center when the piston is nearest to the crankshaft. So here it is the BDC. So, it is nearest to the crankshaft. So, TDC and the BDC. And displacement volume or swept volume, VS. So, the nominal volume swept by the piston when traveling from one dead center to the other is called as displacement volume. It is expressed in terms of cubic centimeter. So, VS equal to pi by 4 d square into L. So, pi by 4 d square is the cross-sectional area. L is the stroke length. And the clearance volume, the nominal volume of the combustion chamber above the piston when it is at top dead center is called the clearance volume, and it is expressed in centimeter, cubic centimeter. So when the piston is at the top dead center, the volume above the piston is called as clearance volume. And the compression ratio, it is ratio of the total cylinder volume when the piston is at the bottom dead center to the clearance volume designated by the letter R. So, R equal to Vs plus Vc divided by Vc. So, Vs plus Vc is when the piston is at the bottom dead center, the volume is stroke volume plus clearance volume divided by Vc, the clearance volume. That is the volume when the piston is at the volume when the piston is at the top dead center. So, this Vs equal to pi by 4 d square into L, and R equal to Vs plus Vc divided by Vc. These two are important equations for solving the problem. And coming to the Otto cycle. So, Otto cycle was invented by Nicholas A. Otto, a German mechanical engineer, in the year 1876. And the Otto cycle is the ideal thermodynamic cycle for petrol engine or spark ignition engine. So in the IC engine, we'll be studying about the working of the petrol engine or the spark ignition engine, but the Otto cycle is the basic thermodynamic cycle for petrol engine. And look at the diagram, PV and the temperature entropy diagram. So the Otto cycle constitute four processes, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 1. Look at the process, 1 to 2 isentropic process, it is compression, 2 to 3 constant volume process, it is heat addition, 3 to 4 again isentropic process expansion, and 4 to 1, it is again constant volume process, heat rejection. So there are four processes, 1 to 2 isentropic compression process, 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition process, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion process, and 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection process. And what is happening in all the four processes? So we take 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 1. So we take the four properties, pressure, volume, temperature and entropy. For isentropic compression, pressure increases from P1 to P2, volume decreases from V1 to V2, temperature increases, look at here, temperature increases and entropy is constant. Isentropic means constant entropy, so S1 equal to S2. And 2 to 3, reversible constant volume heat addition. So heat addition process at a constant volume, so temperature, pressure increases, 2 to 3, volume remains constant, temperature increases and entropy is also increasing. Because of the heat addition, entropy is also increasing. And 3 to 4, isentropic expansion. So the pressure, look at here, pressure decreases from P3 to P4 and the volume increases from V2 to, V3 equal to V2, V4 equal to V1. So it is volume is increasing. Temperature decreases, T3 to T4, and entropy remains constant, S3 equal to S4. And 4 to 1, reversible constant volume heat rejection. So, pressure decreases from P4 to P1. The temperature volume is constant, so V4 equal to V1. And here, temperature decreases, entropy is also decreasing. For heat rejection, both temperature and the entropy decreases. So, these are the four processes in the Otto cycle. Now the heat supplied. So the heat supplied during this process. So look at here, where is heat supplied? Here heat is supplied. It is constant volume process. Heat supplied equal to MCV into T3 minus T2. So heat supplied equal to MCV into T3 minus T2. And the heat rejected. So from the 4 to 1 process, it is MCV into T4 minus T1. And we know that efficiency of thermodynamic cycle, Otto cycle, equal to net to work done divided by the heat supply. So W net divided by the heat supplied, which is QS minus QR divided by QS, which is equal to 1 minus QR by QS, equal to 1 minus, you substitute for QR, MCV T4 minus T1, and QS MCV into T3 minus T2. So M into CV, that is cancelled. So finally, what is left out? 1 minus T4 minus T1. Divided by T3 minus T2, which is equal to, in the numerator, we take T1 outside. So when T1 is taken outside, T1 into T4 by T1 minus 1. And in the denominator, we take T2 outside. This becomes T3 by T2 minus 1. So we have 1 minus T1 into T4 by T1 minus 1 divided by T2 into T3 by T2 minus 1. Now for isentropic compression and expansion process. For compression process, isentropic compression process, what is isentropic compression? 1 to 2. So T2 by T1 equal to V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1. Already we defined V1 by V2 equal to R, compression ratio. Volume V1 divided by V2 equal to compression ratio R to the power gamma minus 1. And for expansion process, T3 by T4 equal to V4 by V3. How to remember? Look at the temperature ratio T2 by T1, volume ratio the reverse V1 by V2. T3 by T4, volume ratio V4 by V3 to the power gamma minus 1, and V4 equal to V1 and V3 equal to V2. So this is again R to the power gamma minus 1. So finally, T2 by T1 equal to T3 by T4 equal to V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1. We take the first two terms, T2 by T1 equal to T3 by T4, cross multiply. We can replace T4 and T2. So T4 by T1 equal to T3 by T1. So you subtract 1 on both sides. So T4 by T1 minus 1 equal to T3 by T2 minus 1. Now these two are cancelled. So T4 by T1 minus 1 equal to T3 by T2 minus 1. So what is left out? Auto cycle efficiency equal to 1 minus T1 by T2, which is equal to 1 minus 1 by T2 by T1, which is equal to 1 minus 1 by T2 by T1 equal to V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, which is equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. Now look at the equation. Auto cycle efficiency depends on R and gamma minus 1. R is the compression ratio. Gamma is the adiabatic index. So R is the compression ratio, which is V1 by V2, and gamma is Cp by Cv, adiabatic index for the air. Now there are two variables for influencing the auto cycle efficiency. One is compression ratio and the adiabatic index. How they are changing, how they are influencing, we will see. R is the compression ratio V1 by V2, which is the volume at the beginning of the compression divided by volume at the end of the compression, which is equal to Vs plus Vc divided by the Vc. That is volume when the piston is at the bottom dead center divided by volume when the piston is at the top dead center. The efficiency of the auto cycle depends on the compression ratio and the ratio of specific heat. Increasing the compression ratio will increase the efficiency. However, the compression ratio of the typical engine is 7 to 10. For petrol engine, the compression ratio is limited to 7 to 10. So look at here, the x-axis value, compression ratio, y-axis auto cycle efficiency. This is how the efficiency is changing. And the range of compression ratio for petrol engine is 7 to 10. And there is another parameter which is influencing the efficiency, gamma value, gamma equal to K. So it is given as K here. So gamma is replaced by K here. So K equal to 1.67, that is gamma equal to 1.667, gamma equal to 1.4 and gamma equal to 1.3. When the gamma value increases, the efficiency increases. That is what the relationship between gamma and the efficiency of the auto cycle. Next we calculate the net work output of the auto cycle. So net work output equal to expansion work minus the compression work. Expansion work is P3 V3 minus P4 V4 divided by gamma minus 1 minus compression work is P2 V2 minus P1 V1 divided by gamma minus 1. So rearranging. So we take P1 V1 outside and gamma minus 1 is a common term outside. So P3 V3 by P1 V1 minus P4 V4 by P1 V1 minus P2 V2 by P1 V1 plus 1. And substituting in terms of pressure ratio. Pressure ratio equal to P3 by P1 and the compression ratio is V1 by V2. Substituting net work done equal to P1 V1 by gamma minus 1 into Rp minus 1 into R to the power gamma minus 1 minus 1. So Rp is the pressure ratio, which is P3 by P1, R is the compression ratio, which is V1 by V2. And the mean effective pressure. So mean effective pressure is defined as net work output divided by the swept volume. And you remember this equation. We are not, sometimes we may solve problem to calculate the mean effective pressure, but we are not going to use the complicated mathematical equation. We remember this equation. Mean effective pressure equal to net work output divided by the swept volume. So from the previous equation, we substitute the net work done divided by swept volume is V1 minus V2. So swept volume is volume between TDC and BDC. So this V1 minus V2 is the swept volume. And simplifying, we will get mean effective pressure equal to P1 into R into Rp minus 1 into R to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma minus 1 into R minus 1. So in the two derivations, which is the important equation that you have to remember, is mean effective pressure, which is net to work output divided by the swept volume, which will be useful for solving the problem. And we stop here. So from the discussion, that's all about the auto cycle. So what do you have to remember? The PV diagram, TS diagram of the auto cycle. the efficiency of the Otto cycle, eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, where R is the compression ratio. The compression ratio for the Otto cycle is in the range of 7 to 10. And when the compression ratio increases, the efficiency of the Otto cycle increases. These are all the points you have to remember. So from the discussion, we answer few questions, theory questions here. The air standard Otto cycle comprises two constant volume processes and two constant entropy processes, two constant pressure processes and two constant volume, constant entropy processes, two constant volume processes and two constant pressure processes, none of the above. So the answer is two constant volume processes and two constant entropy processes. Thermal efficiency of Otto cycle increases with increase in compression ratio, increases with increase in isentropic index, is independent of the pressure ratio. Follow all the above. So, first three statements are correct. Follows all the above. It is increasing with increase in compression ratio. It is increasing with increase in isentropic index. It is independent of the pressure ratio. An ideal air standard Otto cycle has a compression ratio of 8.5. The ratio of specific heat of air is 1.4. What is the thermal efficiency of the Otto cycle in percentage? 57.5, 45.7, 52.5 and 95%. We take the equation. Eta equal to Otto cycle efficiency, eta equal to 1 minus R to the power gamma minus 1. So 1 minus 1 by 8.5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.575. which is 57.5%. So the answer is 57.5%. And these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for further information. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it for more information. I conclude the lecture with a quote from Dr. Abdul Kalam. Dream is not which you see while sleeping. It is something that does not let you sleep. So remember and work hard for your better future. And these are all the books I published earlier. So design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machines. And I have a YouTube channel where I have uploaded video lectures of all the subjects. Also the solution for the gate question paper. So you refer the book and subscribe the YouTube channel for better learning in mechanical engineering or to pass the competitive GATE examination. So thank you for watching. You please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for further information or clarification. Thank you for watching once again. We'll meet again.